Hey everyone, I'm meteorologist Matt Serwey. A relatively quiet morning. The rain really fell apart quickly across the area early Wednesday. Take a look at the radar right now. Very little across the Omaha metro. Just a couple of sprinkles that moved through between about 9 and 10 o'clock. A few light rain showers earlier this morning. But you can see the main batch of rain was mainly to our south. And there were a few thunder showers right along the Kansas-Nebraska border. So maybe along Fairbury to Wymore Springs into Pawnee and Falls City. That's where you heard a few rumbles of thunder. Clouds already starting to decrease off to our west. Notice off to our south and west along I-70, there's your outflow boundary. Any afternoon thunderstorms that we would see would be probably in that direction. There's another little outflow boundary off to our north and west. You can see it from about southwest tip of the panhandle back into central South Dakota. So those are going to be the two areas that we're watching into this afternoon for any type of thunderstorm development. What does that mean for Omaha? Well, it means that we're going to be dry. We're going to see more sun by the middle of the day, still maybe a lingering shower off to our south and southeast. High temperatures in the low to mid 80s this afternoon, and it will be on the muggier side once again. By 8 o'clock, that 20% chance for rain is going to be either off to our north or off to our south, depending on which one of those outflow boundaries wants to get going quicker. So good news if you're going to the Huskers game at TD Ameritrade. Again, around first pitch, temperature should be in the low to mid 70s. If you're going to the Hawkeyes game later this evening, we will be staying dry. It's just that late game at about 9 o'clock. I know it's a late first pitch, let me tell you. Toward the end of that game, maybe an isolated thundershower gets in here. You see on our computer model at 10 o'clock, a couple of isolated thundershowers moving toward the I-80 corridor, and then maybe a rumble of thunder here or there overnight. But I think everyone gets a full night of sleep. Trust me, I am very excited about that. Tomorrow could be a pretty busy day around here. Notice tomorrow morning, we get an outflow boundary to our south. We have a stalled front. You can see the clouds from Columbus back toward Ottawa. So there are several boundaries we're going to be watching as we go into Thursday afternoon. You can start to see thunderstorms firing up in central Nebraska late in the afternoon, and then into the evening, they start to move east. And overnight, we could see repeated rounds of heavier rainfall around here with additional strong to severe thunderstorms. Now, I want to show you the severe weather outlook for tomorrow. Again, this is tomorrow. Slight risk across most of the KETV viewing area. That enhanced risk in the orange is likely where we'll have the best tornado potential. It'll be along either a warm front that's going to be off to our south toward the Kansas-Nebraska border, or along a stationary boundary that's been parked pretty much across Minnesota, Iowa, and Nebraska over the last couple of days. So bottom line, I would expect to see some heavy rainfall, a lot of lightning, some big rumbles of thunder on Thursday, but there's also that potential for large hail, damaging winds, and even a few tornadoes. So we'll be keeping a close eye on that tomorrow, and then the rain continues, even possibly more heavy rain into parts of Memorial Day weekend. You can check out that forecast of 7 days here on KETV.com. Again, it's not good for Memorial Day weekend. Just plan on Sunday. That's your dry day. Chief Meteorologist Bill Ramby is going to be in later this afternoon to update the forecast here and on KETV News Watch 7 at 5. Get out and enjoy an almost summer-like afternoon, and get ready for the potential for severe weather tomorrow. I'll have the latest tomorrow morning on First News Thursday.